in the Ram Shack getting student interviews.
And we're doing interviews from the barbershop.
So stick with us because we got a great show. Now, what barbershop do you get your hair cut at?
Big Time. As you can see, I got a fresh cut right here. Maybe I need a little another lineup. Big Time. It's on Walltown. I recommend to all my boys. Prices are good. They sell clothes in there. They do women's eyebrows, a whole nine. Big Time. It's the spot to be at, right on Walltown.
I'm just wondering, where do you get your hair cut?
Fresh cuts right down the street. $7 for everything.
Do you like it?
Yeah, I like it.
Would you suggest it to anyone else?
Oh, yeah, I suggest it to everybody, especially if you're broke.
There's a lot of talking going on at all times about it, any subject you can think of, just like in barbershop, and they're sitting there joking on people. It's a fun atmosphere.
People come in and sell that junk, you know, that junk that people be trying to sell, them, you know, people be dressed up with them ties and stuff, they're trying to sell that stuff. Don't nobody ever buy that. And they keep dropping the price on it. They come in and start at like $12 and they end out like a dollar.
And spark ideas as well in the community. You know, get to know people, learn different personalities.
This is Tanya.
And I'm Sharia.
And I'm Alexis.
And we are here at CNC Barbershop Cut and Curl. Provides all services here off of North Point Boulevard.
You ever cut your own hair?
Yeah, barbershop was basically a place where the community could come together and, you know, find out what's going on. It's like a meeting place. It's more than just a place you can get a haircut. Socialize. You can find out what's going on in town, upcoming events, ball games, and, you know, you have it. You can find it all out in the barbershop.
I'll be the other woman. Oh, in your life. Just as long as I'm the only one other than your wife. Your wife, how would she feel if she caught us together?
I'm here with my friend DP. We're at the theater. Going to ask people questions about Barbershop 2 and what did they think about it. And I meant to ask you, did you watch Barbershop 1?
Yes, I did get a chance to see that movie.
And you are a male, so you do get your hair cut, correct?
Whenever my grandmother finds the time, you know, with arthritis and stuff that she's battling.
Yeah, your line looks a little crooked, you know? Just a little bit. Okay, so we're interviewing people about the movie Barbershop 2 and their feelings and their emotions, whether it portrayed their real barbershop ideas. So check it out, guys. What did you think about Barbershop 2?
It was pretty interesting. Some of the things about the barbershop seemed kind of extreme to me. Because my husband goes to the barbershop, and it's not like that at all.
Okay, you barbershop. Don't think it is, mm-mm. As a lady?
No.
Okay, what about Queen Latifah and her little beauty shop role?
Well, I mean, that sounds like some barbershop, some beauty shops. A lot of gossiping, a lot of, you know, doing some things that, you know, to make the customer think you look good, but they really don't look good.
Okay, you know, don't tell us too much about the movies, for those who didn't know. Where do you get your hair done?
I get my hair done at the studio in Winston.
Okay, and so you enjoy your experience there?
Yes, my hairdresser's name is Anna, and she's very nice, very professional.
All right, you know, your hair is looking good, I want to say. Can I get a side view? Okay, ladies, you see that.
We're out here trying to, you know, get everything situated. Where do you get your hair done here?
I do my own hair, you know. That's all, ladies. You know, gotta be cheap. We in college.
So check out the interviews, and we'll get back to you. Did you enjoy the movie Barbershop 2?
Yeah, I did. I thought it was really funny.
Was there anything in the movie that you felt was realistic, you know, with where you go get your hair done at?
Actually, I do my own hair. So as far as a barbershop setting, I don't really go to the barbershop. But I know as far as, like, my aunts and people that I know that do go to the barbershop, they sit and they talk the same way they was talking in the movie. So I did think it was very realistic.
Okay, and you said you do your own hair. Yeah. Do you have many clients here in Winston-Salem?
No, I'm just strictly to myself. I don't like to be bothered with a lot of different things. I know what I like, and I stick to it, so I just keep it to myself.
Okay. Have you had opportunity to see the first barbershop?
Yes, I did.
And which one do you feel was more realistic towards?
The second one. The second one was a lot better. It was more put together. It was just a lot better all together.
What did you think about the movie Barbershop 2?
I thought it was good. I enjoyed it.
You enjoyed it?
Mm-hmm.
Do you get your hair done locally around here?
No. I live in Charlotte. I just came in town for a couple of days, but I'm from Winston.
Are you?
Yeah.
Okay. Were there any topics in the movie that you felt were realistic to, you know, things that go on in your hair salon or things that, you know, topics that y'all might speak with, anything you felt was, you know, realistic from the movie?
Yeah.
You care to give an example?
I mean, I'm just thinking of, like, I don't know, the scene where the girl asked if she looked like Beyonce and, you know, hairdressers tell you what you want to hear.
Oh, okay.
Something like that.
What did you think about the movie Barbershop 2?
I thought it was really good. It was real funny.
Real funny movie? Yeah. Did you get your hair cut around here locally?
Not locally. I'm from Statesville.
Statesville?
I'm just up here visiting tonight.
Okay. Was there anything in the movie that you felt was similar to the topics that go on, you know, at your barbershop?
Oh, definitely. Definitely. It just, to me, it portrayed exactly what goes on in the barbershop, at least a black establishment.
Right.
You know, you go in there, you know, you know pretty much everybody by name when you go in the spot.
Right, right.
You know, y'all sit back, you know, talk about politics, whatever's going on, and everything's level.
Right. Did you
makes it homey, you know, you want to go back there all the time.
Okay. Did you have a chance to see the first barbershop?
Yeah.
Did you like that one better than this one, or did you feel this one was more...
I think they did it a little bit better this time.
A little bit better?
Yeah.
Think it was more realistic this time than the first one?
Yeah.
That's what's up.
And what did you feel about the movie Miracle?
It was very well done. Very true to the history.
All right, could you tell us maybe like a little bit of...
It was USA hockey team that came together in the Olympics and just tried very hard and beat the best team in the world.
All right, and are you a hockey fan,
Jason? Yes, I am.
And what's your favorite team?
Well, currently the Canes.
Canes. And have you ever played hockey before?
No.
No? Okay. So do you feel the movie was overall good and worth $7.25?
Yes.
What movie did you just come out of?
I just came out of Butterfly Effect.
And what did your overall impression about the movie?
It was a pretty good movie, but... It could have been better. It could have been a lot better. The best part of it was at the ending when he finally did save the day, you know, change everything. But he basically had to give up everything in order to change it.
So do you feel it was different than most movies that come out, or did you feel it fit a specific stereotype of a certain type of movie?
Actually, I don't think it was any type of stereotype. It was like a unique movie in itself. Mm-hmm. I mean, it was a good movie. I mean, it was a good movie. I've not seen any other movies like it before.
And do you feel it was worth your $7.25?
Yeah.
And you would recommend it to anybody?
Well, I mean, you have to be in a certain genre. I mean, you have to know what... You have to like certain weird, strange things. I mean, if you don't like the movie... I mean, if you don't... If you're not open-minded, people won't like the movie.
That's what's up.
All right, and where do you get your hair cut at?
My ex-boyfriend used to cut my hair.
Did he?
Yes, he did. You know, my hair was as low as yours, so.
Right.
Yeah.
And so, like, what happened? Did he just stop all of a sudden? Because.
Yes.
Yes, he, as you can see, he did stop. He did. And he will not continue, and neither would I. So, I hope you enjoy the interviews. Let's check them out.
Do I have a good time?
Yeah,
I think so. It's not as good as it was when we first started opened up here, because there's so many barbershops in town. It's not really enough people to accommodate all the shops here in town. There's a shop just about on every corner. So,
so how do you market yourself as opposed to other barbershops? Or is it a secret?
It's not a secret, but I try to give good service.
Okay.
Yeah.
The home feel, make them feel.
Yeah, I want you to feel at home and give good service.
Monte, how long have you been cutting hair, Monte?
About 5 years.
What do you enjoy about cutting hair?
Being my own boss, being creative, and making people smile.
Okay, I think one of his customers has something to say to the camera.
Nothing.
He is ready to get his haircut and move on out.
I can't get my haircut and talk at the same time. I
understand.
So you do ladies' haircut?
I do it right here. I dry and wash right there in the back.
So what do you know how to do a doobie?
I can, and I have done some, but that's not my specialty. I like shortcuts better.
Oh, do you?
Yeah,
you remember how the old stereotypes be, if a guy did hair, they were, feminine. What do you think about that stereotype?
What do I think? My opinion, the great male hairdressers are.
Yeah.
that's beside the point. They're still professionals and they do good work. But I do know a lot of hairdressers that are not good.
So how do you market yourself?
How do I market my hair? My work?
Your work speaks for itself.
Mm-hmm. Plus, I try to, you know, tell people what I do.
The reason we're here, we're going to get some interviews and from the barbers and some customers because a lot of Winston-Salem State students come and get their hair cut here.
How long have you been cutting hair?
In this barbershop, 8 years.
8 years. What do you enjoy about cutting hair?
I ain't got an answer to nobody. I can come and go as I please. Okay. And still make good money.
And would you say fresh cuts would correlate with the movie Barbershop today?
Yes, it will. It kind of was a good depiction of barbershops across America.
Barbershop 1 really did portray the original barbershop. Never said the original. Now, barbershops have changed a great deal from that time. But that was, when I started barbering, it was basically similar to that. It was probably more of a meeting place for people than a barbershop. It's kind of like a country club. Yeah, kind of like a country place to go to when you didn't have nowhere else to go. I always go there and probably get a game of checks or meet old friends. And then you can get service there too. So they had a bigger part than just haircutting. It was more like a social club.
Yeah.
How long have you been a customer here at Fresh Cuts?
Let me see. That's a good question. I used to go to another barbershop on the other side of town, but I've been coming up here about five years.
What do you enjoy? What do you enjoy about coming into your male sanctuary?
Well, of course I enjoy getting my hair cut. Let me see what else. I mean, you know, the fellowship is good. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's good. It's good to build with some brothers, you know what I'm saying?
But you can get empowered. They empower black brothers.
We're at another barbershop today, guys. It's called Inspiration.
Yes,
Inspiration.
Yes, it is.
Design.
Yes, it is. Inspiration Hair Design.
Guys, check this out. Hair design. Check this out. I got to tell you. This barbershop has a game room. As you can see, the guys are playing Madden right now. Popular game, guys. So, is this open to the public, guys?
Yeah, as long as you're coming out here getting service.
Oh, you get service? You can play games too, guys. And they, guess what? They even have a George Foreman. If you bring your own hot dogs, that's a bonus sheet. You can't burn. So we're going to tour around the barbershop, see what they can do. And we'll get back to you, but that's what's up. How did you get into the business of
I mean, one day I just decided, I've been cutting all through high school, college, or whatever.
Okay.
So one day I just decided I'd be my own business.
Okay. So have you said that you've done
pretty good?
Okay, so how do you market yourself?
I want to say my
other than other barbers. What do you do special?
Advertising. Word of mouth is good.
If you're a guy that's got a lot of bills, a family, small children, it's really not the type of business to go into, right? You should start it when you're young if you want to really make something out of it.
That's what's up.
That's what's up, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Come on, you get on camera?
Yeah, we got him. We are here at Inspiration Hair Design. We're talking to the owner. What's your name?
Cedric.
Okay. Yeah. And we are located where?
784 North Fort Worth.
Okay. And how did you get into the business of cutting
hair? I mean, one day I just decided I've been cutting all through high school, college, or whatever.
Okay.
So one day I just decided I'd be my own business.
Okay. So have you said that
Okay,
so how do you market?
Sit on the car.
It ain't pretty like that. You said it'd be
give student discounts.
Can yes, I do? Yes, I do.
What's the student discount?
Oh, you give me a... Okay. The show of college I did.
And how much would you get?
$5 haircuts. You have to talk to my stylist about the hair.
Okay, so they do give student lines. Ladies, we need to get our hair done. That's what's up?
That's what's up.
Is that? That's what's up.
That's what's up.